get some music going here. What's good? Guess I can make this a little bigger. Haha. All right. Good, good, good. Recently played. Come on, Spotify. Don't be a jerk. Computer so slow. Okay. Okay, let's close this. Close. What else? What else can I close? I can close that. Can close that. I can close that. Okay. Oh my gosh, Spotify, you're so daggum slow. All right, there we go. Jeez Louise. Miles, shut up, Kitty. Come on. Yep. All right. Got that going. Good. Okay. Welcome, welcome, welcome. How's everyone doing today? We're going to be diving into the Butch King puzzle. So this is one that I put out 2 years ago, at about this time. It was 2 years and 2 months ago on Obsidian Ocean. It ran for about a week, and it was so difficult that everyone who attempted it quit eventually. Hey Miles, what's up? Oh, he's on the other side. Haha. So yeah, everyone who attempted this puzzle ended up quitting because of how difficult it was. And one girl in particular, Malia, I don't know if you remember her, but she got really, really close, but she just couldn't figure out the last bits. So this one has been changed, altered, probably made 50% easier. And then some other things were changed. I took out some of the more cruel, misleading things that Butch King says and stuff. But here's the gist. So, if you hadn't already started the puzzle before, this is Butch King. Hello. And this puzzle is unique because you have to interact with this guy in order to like get the puzzle done. So, if I had to, I wonder if I could just like kind of. I think I'll work it out using paint.net. It's a great tool. So, basically, you've got Butch King here, and he is connected to the plot because he's got all these ribbons. And so there would be like a ribbon over here for when you went into his crew hall and figured out the puzzle there, and there's a ribbon for figuring out what's in the wardrobe, and there's or on the trinket case, and there's a ribbon here for figuring out that you need to dress worse than he is dressed in order to get a clue. So each one of these ribbons is a clue. So that's kind of one half of the puzzle. I'm going to show you my spreadsheet now. So this is my spreadsheet of specific and random responses. Like if the room is quiet for like 5 minutes, I'll just shout out one of these random things. Only a few of them actually give hints towards the puzzle. For instance, this one being about being afraid of water. This one might question get people to talk about brigand kings, but let's just go ahead and get into the ribbons. And then also let's talk about the riddle book. We'll start with the riddle book because that's the most approachable thing. So Butch King is gonna go to his crew hall on Admiral Island now. Alright, how's the stream doing? Yeah, Malia. That was her name on Obsidian Ocean. Okay, so we have this room in here. This is probably the most important part, is this book right here, the Book of Riddles. So in the story, Booch King's dad had a Book of Riddles, and so we're going to take a look at it now. There was a little link to it. So it brings you to a document online, and each of these, turn the music down a little bit, each of these riddles has an answer that is a number. So that's one important thing to note, is that each of these riddles has a number for an answer. And there's also 26 riddles. So to come back over here, there are 26 riddles, and so 26, that's that number that you can always relate to the alphabet. So riddle number one is really riddle A, okay? And the answer to A, which I'll go ahead and look up now, is 6. So whenever you see 06 in the ribbons, which we'll talk about second, then you know that 6 is the letter A. So let's get into it, right? We have the most unfortunate of hammers, how many turns ended its clamor? So that is actually referring to the blacksmithing puzzle. So what would the most unfortunate of hammers, how would it end? You would have a 4 here, and then a 4 here, and then a 4 here, and a 4 here, and a 4 here, and a 4 here. And then that would technically be it. If you were to click a 4 here and it started on a chain of 4s, technically you could end this puzzle in 6 turns. So the answer is 6, okay? I'm going to pull up my little guide here too. There we go. So, riddle B. If not for Feline Engineer, I can't imagine we'd be here. This is a reference to 80 Cats, who is the software engineer, one of the software engineers for Puzzle Pirates. So 80 is the number. Riddle C. Our captain and his one-eyed mate, this many times began our fate. If you go and you research into the Spyglass and into the Puzzle Pirates website, you'll find that our captain, whose name was, why is that escaping me right now? Oh my gosh. Am I that terrible? Someone help me out with this. But anyways, One-Eyed Jack and, what is his freaking name? It's not Nemo. Was it Nemo? Somebody help me in the chat. Cleaver, thank God. Jesus. Cleaver. So Cleaver and One-Eyed Jack, were the creators of the game, the co-creators of the game, and they started Alpha 19 times. So that's where this number 19 comes from. Next one, dull green ocean insurmounted, ocean masters must be counted. I actually have the explanations here. I should just unhide them. Unhide. Okay. That's the number of Spanish ocean masters. So I think it's Clotho and Atropos. All right. A captain's wheel in center spot, what's left you'll have to count the lot. So that is referring to a shipwrightery puzzle. If there is a helm, or the captain's wheel, in the middle of the shipwrightering puzzle, if I can just get into this a little bit bigger, then you have 20 spots left on the puzzle. Okay, moving on. Number 6, I need to go ahead and advertise again. Are you... Watch the stream. Okay, so the next one. A pirate has nothing left to gain. With all tabs closed, what tabs remain? So if you were to... I think I have like an earlier version of this that goes into more detail. Hold on. I'll show you the one that was from 2 years ago too. This thing was a monster. So it's got It's got some of the responses. It's got, here's the progressions that shows all the scrolls. And there were a lot more back then, as you can see. And some of them were fake. The pink ones were fake. Butch King moved around every day. You could take him on like a CI. You could take him on a pillage. You could take him to a Brigand King battle. Okay, but the ciphers are mostly the same, so I'll resort to this one. So the number of tabs with all minimized, that would be like potions, maps, portraits, furniture. But if you count them all up, eventually you get to 15, right? Unobtainable, this arm. Its teeth, when sunk, would do you harm. Jesus, I need to wake up. That's the number of teeth in a trident. So that's 3. How's the stream doing? Do you stream Puzzle Pirates exclusively? Yeah, dude. I stream nothing else. This is it. Let's see. My little green screen's messing up. Go! Okay, there we go. Haha. So, yeah. So, three trident teeth. But I don't really like stream Puzzle Pirates because I don't even play the puzzles. I play poker and I make puzzles. So, anyways. Let's see. 2 sabers cross, you must exalt. For that, 1 pirate's an old salt. That is referring to, what? Oh, yeah. The 13th order of the Jolly Roger trophy has 2 sabers crossed. So it's 13 is the answer there. Okay. Bubbles brewing in the fermenter, split by things that could enter. So there are 85, there are 85 different spots for a bubble in the distilling puzzle. And there are 5 different kinds of bubbles. So 85 divided by 5, that gives you the answer of 17. Okay, all right. LOL. I think my wife changed the music on me. The Daffodil Trophy awarded when a player has 10 portraits of themselves. So, was this a dream or in a book? A yellow flower and a hook. That is the trophy that you get for the portraits. So, the number's 10. So, imagine that. The 10th letter is 10. Okay, so then the next one. How much labor must you spend to build a Butch-named chair for a friend? This is in reference to the King Chair. Q-I-N-G takes a little bit of going with it in order to come to that conclusion. But if you go to a furnishing stall, the king chair is obviously the one that would be named the most butchiest, right? Next one, it's hull repair. When, where, who, buy, and what's the frequency of why? So you can actually go on the on the Wikipedia article for carpentry and find out that the Y piece in carpentry has a 14 out of 95 chance of occurring. So the answer to that one is 14. The cost to start a life anew, but keep successes close to you. That is 30 rogue marts to change your name. 30. So the answer to this one's 30. These puzzle pieces pirates did revere, but it's only an item here. That's referring to the 32 pieces that go on a chessboard. Chess was a game that historically pirates played, but it's only a furniture item in the actual game. Let's see. Then we have large butterfly boxes with spiders in them. If you could rotate some, what's filled to the brim? So actually I had to change this one in the original one. One of the people corrected me and said that even though my answer was like the answer, it was not actually possible to achieve on a board. So I changed the wording so that it would make more sense. But basically, if you were to go to a foraging puzzle, let's use Ozzy's video. Rest in peace, Ozzy. All right, so if you were to take a large chest, you could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 large chests could fit in a foraging board. So that's the answer there. All right. A lot of people had questions about this one, the timely death of E. Paulette, a decision that I now regret. So that's referring to the E. Paulette jacket. And if you go on the YPpedia, the E. Paulette jacket, which is a female coat item, decays in 90 days. So the answer is 90. The next one, the last of items you can place, how many symbols around its face? If you go to YPpedia again and you look at all the furniture items and you go to the very last list of Z, you will see the zodiac wheel, and there are 12 symbols around the zodiac wheel's face. Okay. What else? Let's see. Next one. This chicken by mistake once manned with fewer than 100 band. Another YPpedia. This is in reference to El Pollo Diablo. One of the articles in YPpedia says that one time the black ship was actually manned by 8 pirates instead of more than 100, which it usually is. Onomatopoeia sound, legendary combo pound. That's in reference to the largest combo possible in rumbling, which is 37. Enjoy all of Cerulean, but without a pesky payment plan. That's talking about 42 doubloons is what it costs to dubscribe to an ocean. All right, number 21. When thinking of the seasons four, but all white shoulder seasons more. That's talking about what's on your shoulder and is white. White familiars. And so you got white familiars through the OCL seasons. So there were 7 OCL seasons. All right, for your team's sake, when you go blind, end with this number or be fined. So that's the reference to going blind nil, or in the spades game. So that's what that's talking about. Then 3,090 bones, one place, wait just an hour, count foes you'll face. Distracted really liked this one. He was the winner. 3,090 bones. If you divide that by the amount of bones in the human body, which I believe is 206, then you come up with 15, I think? And then if you wait an hour and you're with 15 skeletons on an island, because you know they leave, one skeleton leaves every 5 minutes, technically it would bring you down to 3 skeletons. However, another fun fact is that you can only get down to a minimum of 5 skeletons, so the answer would be 5. It doesn't go any lower than 5. All right, here is the 24th one. Mates, let's join in pirate song, but not the one that's far too long. That's in reference to 99 bottles of beer on the wall. Long ago, potions at stake decide spontaneously to break. That is in reference to, it used to be that the alchemistry puzzle, it gave you 75 turns to fill some of the like larger vials before they would just break. It's another YPpedia reference. And then 26, I want to write what's on my mind, but your guestbook is so unkind. 45 characters is the maximum amount that you can type into a guestbook. So now, presumably, we would have 26 different letters, A through Z, and then each one of those letters would be correlating to a 2-digit number. Or if it's a single digit, you can think of it as like 01, 02, 03, right? So that doesn't really help us all that much. We have a cipher, but we don't have the actual answers. So let's go through each of the ribbons, okay? So we come back here. We'll start with the one over here because then I can spend the rest of my time doing other ones. Let me check in with the stream here. Thought I was so clever figuring out the bones one, SMH, LOL. 21 got me for agers. I wonder if 37 is actually possible. To which one? Let's see. Oh, yeah. You should try that out, yeah. It'd be interesting. But they programmed it. Weird. Let me go ahead and do another ad here. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. Okay, so so this one, there's only one puzzle in this room, and that is if you come down here, you will see that there's our winner right there. You will see that it's sort of like a maze, and there's a final point here. And it doesn't really make any sense out of context, but there's a persimmon ribbon there. So then the solution to this is that you go into this other room. In this other room, there are a combination of X's and numbers. And if you look closely, they are 8 wide and 7 long. So then you would take this and you would actually go and overlay the spaces in the room. I don't know if you guys can see that. You overlay the spaces in the room with the numbers and the X's. So if you start at the front, you go 052006. I accidentally added an extra one here, which the winner called me out on, and I messed up one other time. But the gist of it is that you get a code, and then this code, if you plug it into your cipher, you get the word wealth. WEALTH. Okay? So that is the one for this house. Let's move to his longship. This one's pretty easy. I forgot because I gave him the the longship as a prize, but the gist of it was there was a ribbon on the ship, and the ship in the officer's notes said that the ship was purchased at a specific time, and if you crunch the numbers there and turn them into a word, then you would get, let me go over here. There it is. You would get the word when. So now you know the first word and the last word of this puzzle. First of all, the whole password is, oh, thanks, Distract, appreciate it. So if you go down in here, you will see the trinket case has this looped ribbon yellow. So you know it's the yellow ribbon. And then the only other thing on the ship is the officer notes, which I still can't see. Don't worry about it, Distracted, it's fine. But it just has these numbers basically. 05132032. Okay? So then, oh yeah, thanks. This ship was purchased 05132032. Perfect. So then, let's see, is there anything else outside of the room? Yes. There, Booch King owns he owns a ironmongering stall. So we're gonna go here and go to his stall. So in his stall, he's got a light blue ribbon, and the information says foil, labor minus total enamel, small CVs, total units, medium CV iron units, and Dedao Massey units. So all of those numbers together, they're four different numbers, and they would give you the 13682, and that gives you the word hard. Okay, moving on. I'm trying to think if there's any other places where you had to go to finish this puzzle. I don't think so. So let's move into. Well, actually, I could just check on it, couldn't I? Let me just go over here. All right. Longship puzzle. Ironmonger. Okay. The only other one that's not really in the room, that's not an activity to do in the room, is if you go to Booch King's crew information here. I copy and pasted the damage chart from YPPedia, but there's two or three maybe that are different. Let me check. No, there's two. There's two that I changed. The Grand Frigate down here at the bottom is supposed to have two different numbers, but instead it's 1115. So if anyone called me out on that, I would show them this ribbon. I think this is the one. Yeah, 1115. That didn't seem right for a Grand Frigate, did it? So then you figure out that the purple ribbon is the word if, I think. Or of or something. Of, yeah. Okay. Now, everything else can be done in the back room. Let's, everybody feeling good so far? I'm going to be uploading this online, so. Let's see. Didn't realize you could see the officer's notes as a pirate. To be honest, I didn't even think about that. Oops. So, glad it worked out. Let's see. Sure, I'll just mute you. That's fine. Okay, let's see. Where are we going from here? Let's stick with Booch King and let's go to this. All right. Starting from the top. So if anyone, this was a cue, if anyone were to ask for a hint or a clue, those were the two words, then I would type this right here that says, what, a hint? Are we playing a game? I want to play. I'll show you a hint, but you have to show me a million po. For some people, that was really easy. They just showed me a million po, and then I showed them this this ribbon. But for other people, a million po is hard to come by, so they were clever. They like made trinkets that said 1 million po, or they put in one po and said that's 1 million. Whatever. I gave points to creativity. So that's the first one there, and then that decoded gives you the word your. Let's see. This one, if. So Booch King, by default, sucks at everything. That's the whole joke. But if you were to challenge him to a sword fight and you were to basically kill yourself quicker than me, I would kind of give like a second or two for everyone to try and kill themselves earlier than me. But for the most part, I would immediately straight line. So if you figured it out, then you would get to look at this ribbon, which says, Booch King, you're terrible. If someone ever loses to you, I'll give you this much po, and then those numbers correlate to the word failures. Also, notice the extra work I did in making sure that some of these puzzles lined up with the actual words. So, for example, that one, you had to fail against Booch King in order to get the word failures. And then the next one is similar to that, too. If anyone mentions Brigand Kings, I alluded to the fact that I like Admiral Phineas, and then if someone were to impersonate Admiral Phineas or make up a trinket that looks like Admiral Phineas's trinket or show me a Brigand King trinket of Admiral Phineas or whatever, then I would give them this this ribbon here, which comes out to be the word accompany. Okay. We've got the hard, then okay. If there was a large group of people in the room, I would try to allude to the fact that you could try and come in dressing tackier than me, which would get you a word. But I would say, so many people here, but I'm the boochiest. And for some reason, I said it like 6 or 7 times this weekend, and only once did anyone kind of take it as a challenge. So, yeah. So that was that. You got this green ribbon that had the numbers for work in it. All right, next one. If anyone asked about why Booch King was living in the back of the inn for any reason at all, then he would give, he would show them the rent agreement between Booch King and Jazz, which is here, I think. No. This one, it's the maroon ribbon. And that comes out to the word you, which is clever because Booch King is Jazz. Haha. All right. The next one, if anyone wanted to ask about Booch King's family, they found out the little story that Booch King's dad was a pirate and he left a love letter to his wife and then proceeded to drown. So he is dead. But the love letter, if you asked about it, you would be able to read it. And this one doesn't have numbers. It actually just says, Sarah, I'm sorry that I must depart for the sea voyage. I will always love you. Will, all caps. So that was supposed to allude to the fact that will is the word there. All right. How's chat doing? It was a very sad story. Yes, it was. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Don't subscribe with Twitch Prime. I'll never get that money because I don't have enough viewers. Because there's not enough people that play this stupid game. But, appreciate it. So, let's see. Yeah, also, this was the other mistake that I made. On the failures word, I accidentally made that failure M. So the 0 should have been a 7, or the 7 should have been a 0, or something like that. But it should have been the word failures. So that was the only other time I messed up. Not too bad for someone who doesn't even check his own, double check his own work. Okay, if someone asked, this one was fun. I didn't really get a lot of people asking or like working on this one. But basically, if anyone asked Booch King to search the room for any reason or talked about the bookshelves, he would act like he would go to the bookshelves to go searching, and then he would tell everyone that he found this looped ribbon here, and that loop ribbon comes out to the word find. Haha, clever again. Alright, then if anyone mentions the painting or if something is for sale, Booch King would tell them that his mother is a fine arts dealer and that this painting was for sale, and he would show them the price tag, which was a gold looped ribbon. And that word came out to be the word treasure. So fine art, gold, treasure, more cleverness. All right. This next one was the light green in the trinket case. It had no inscription, which is kind of difficult. But if you were to go and look at Booch King's gallery image, the description says something is carved in the wardrobe. I can't make it out. No, that's not right. But it turns out it just needed to be filled in a little bit more. The word is troves, T-R-O-V-E-S. So thought that would be pretty tricky. I think it was. Let's see. Then the next one was the damage counter. The next one. Okay. This one is usually the most fun. I would randomly say thing if someone talked about wanted to like engage in a drinking puzzle, or if they asked about drinking, or if they asked about a party, or if I cued it by saying one of my random lines that says, there was something about like, you think I'm Booch now, wait till you see me after a few drinks. So that would cue, hopefully, people into thinking that they would try and get me drunk. So getting Booch King drunk, which required a group of 15 people or more in the back of the inn and someone to cue the music, he would start to take drinks. Then he would get really drunk, and then he would put out this looped ribbon that looks like absolute mumbo jumble, if you can kind of zoom in on that. But basically, it was even more to decipher because if you look at it closely, it's saying longship sails, bagless sail plus cart plus bilge plus gun, zebic sail plus cart plus bilge plus gun, dow, bilge, fanchuan, sail plus cart plus bilge plus gun, grand frig sail. So those are all different numbers, and then those numbers correlate to wisdom. The word wisdom. Okay, we're almost there. I think this is the last one. Oh yeah, this one's the easiest one too. Booch King is wearing this trinket, and it just says 6/32/02, best day ever, and that's kind of fishy because there's no 32nd month of the or day of the month. So if you were to decipher that when it's the word and. So the last bit to this puzzle was at the very beginning when people walk in, they see this. The way that corner area is laid out, it's so suspicious. Why did I do that? So it starts over here, and it actually tells you the order of the ribbons. Yellow, red, violet, orange, light blue, green, maroon, lime, brown, gold, I should have said lime there. Lime, brown, gold, light green, purple, magenta, Aqua persimmon. And so that is the list of the ribbons. So if you put them in order, then the final password is when your failures accompany hard work, you will find treasure troves of wisdom and wealth. Whew! Okay, guys. So that was the explanation video. I hope to, of course, put out another puzzle in the near future, but I think I'm good with puzzles for now. This will be uploaded onto YouTube, so if any of your friends ask to see the solution, just have them send me a message. Thanks for all the support. And Lacrim, distracted won the whole thing. He had some help from some other pirates, but they didn't feel like they. I don't know. I don't know why they didn't want to be called out. But we'll just say that distracted. He did do a really bit large amount of the legwork. Apparently, he stayed up till 3 a.m. last night. So, and that's gonna be it from me. Thanks for watching, and let me know if you have any questions. Peace.